There. Good afternoon. I'm Lorraine from Osoyoos, British Columbia, and today we're doing the wellness gathering, health by choice and not by chance, and taking ownership of our well-being series. And today we're going to be doing the letter E with energy, and our guest speaker is Lynn Hilderman. She is the co-owner of the Britannia Body Works Wellness Center in Calgary. And she's a specialist in core alignment clearing and coaching, emotional wisdom training coach, a massage and sacral cranial therapist, reflexologist, and she's an Access Conscious Bars facilitator. So Lynn is going to give us a presentation on energy, and now energy is the aspects of energy is very broad, so one can go very deep into this. So Lynn, I'll just pass it on to you, and we'll just see how much we can touch today. We have probably 15 or 20 minutes.
Yeah. Well, thank you. And yeah, and I guess with this E in our ownership principle here, E also stands for exercise, and exercise kind of goes with energy, because energy, yes, it's a very broad subject, because it actually is how our body is processing information. You know, it's the property of, you know, utilizing the reserves that we have to keep us going forward, to keep us healthy. But also the E is about exercise, and how do we use our bodies to move, to generate more energy. So I thought we could just, you know, I would talk generally about energy, because energy medicine is also a big subject as well. You know, we've got, you know, in different forms of body work where we're moving energy through the body, like even just doing a massage, we're actually manipulating the tissues and moving the energy. You know, in yoga, we're also with our breath. And anytime we take a breath, we are actually moving energy. And, you know, our units, we all have so many units of energy, and where our attention goes, the energy flows. So right now, today, we're going to talk about energy. So put our attention on, you know, just looking at the overall subject of energy and energetics. I'd like to kind of take sort of, you know, noticing our bodies and using our bodies, because, you know, even just rubbing our hands together, we can actually feel the energy, you know, in our bodies. So you can just take your hands and rub them together and just slowly bring them apart and just notice what you notice. I know for myself, I feel a little buzzing kind of feeling. Well, but that's our energy system in our bodies. And so we have an energy body that we can actually take care of, and we can take care of it in different ways. We can take care of it by noticing it, you know, whether I'm feeling light or whether I'm feeling heavy, because sometimes I might all of a sudden feel a little heavy in my body, and I won't really have a reason to think, why am I feeling heavy? So a lot of times noticing the energy in my body has to do with this being feeling light and feeling heavy. So that's one aspect of it. And there was another thought that I had about that. The other thing is, you know, like we often will take care of our physical bodies. So like if we do some form of exercise, when we move our arms, we actually, you know, or any part of our body, we actually increase the flow of energy. When we eat, you know, our body has to process the food through an energy system. So let's just, you know, just close our eyes and take a deep breath in. And just exhale slowly. And take another breath in. And exhale slowly. And notice the quality of your awareness with your breath. And notice your body and where your attention goes in your body. Maybe take your attention and put it on your feet. You know, feel your toes, maybe wiggle them. Maybe roll your ankles. Keeping your, and so just noticing where your attention is going, the energy is going to those body parts. So now bring your attention to your knees. Just putting your attention on your knees. Then bring your attention to your hips, sitting on the chair, wherever you are. You'll probably feel the pressure of the chair holding you, or you sitting on the chair. Just notice that. And then coming up a little higher, maybe put your attention on your chest, on your heart. Maybe you can put your hands on your chest and noticing your breath. This is all you having your attention on different areas. You are actually engaging the energy of your energetic body in relation to your physical body. So in yoga, you know, there's often postures that we hold, or there's pranayama breathing that you can do, but it actually engages that whole system, the chakras are another way of describing, that's another system of energy, of where, how am I caring for my energy system? So that's another aspect of energy. And there's just things that we can do to take care of our energy bodies by sweeping the energy off of our arms. We actually clear the energy, our energy field. Or even like, you know, we're feeling heavy in our shoulders. You can just, it's like dusting. I like to think of it as dusting. So I often think of, you know, our energy is just something we can take care of. And it's something that we can make more or make less. So like with exercise, if I go out and I exercise, I'm actually pumping the blood through my veins and, you know, my breath, I'm engaging my breath. I'm actually increasing the flow of energy in my body, which only makes, you know, all the other systems work better. You know, I actually looked up, you know, what energy actually is defined as, and it said energy is the quantitative property that must be transferred to a body or a physical system to perform work on the body or to heat it. Energy is a conservative quantity. The law of conservation of energy states that energy can convert in form, but not created or destroyed. So energy is constantly going through a transformation process. It's always there. You know, and energy therapies are based on the belief that vital life energy flows through and around our bodies. And the goal of any kind of energy therapy is to unblock the flow of the energy and restore it to its energetic balance. So like in yoga, that it restores us to a better balance. In Chinese medicine with acupuncture, it actually restores the flow of our meridians. And, you know, and like even massage, it flushes the tissues, you know, just by moving the lymph through the body, that helps to calm the energy in the body. So yeah, it's a big subject. So I'd like to ask you guys, what's your experience of energy? Madeline?
Well, I certainly know that feeling of having a very heavy body. And one of the wonderful side effects or results of having your bars run as an access conscious believer, having your bars run makes a huge difference in my energy feelings, put it that way. So it can, you can start off feeling very heavy, and just by going through all the points on your head, having someone basically clear all of that can lighten up how your body feels and how your body responds. So I understand it, having experienced it, a lot better. And also, when I was just a little girl, my mother would do a process with me that was called ragdoll. And it was really just putting your body to sleep. And so she was very focused on knowing that we have control over our body and our energy. And if, you know, if like you say, you know, if you just put your attention on relaxing parts of your body, it behaves, it responds. And so, you know, I didn't put two and two together when I was a little girl, but it was very effective, you know? So I learned that just through her experiencing it, or through me experiencing it from her.
Got it. Yeah.
Thank you. Great.
Yeah. And just to talk about access and so access consciousness bars is a body process. There's just different points on the head that when you just hold them, it actually dissipates it's like emptying the recycle bin on a computer. You know, we often will delete files, but we don't go into that little icon and empty the recycle bin. So by just holding certain points on the head, actually holding our hands on somebody's head right in here will actually calm their whole energy system down. So if somebody is not feeling well or whatever, or in a state, if they were just to lay down and I were to put my hands right beside their neck and shoulders right in here and just barely touch them, if I held my hands there long enough, the energy in their body would calm down. And it's part of healing touch, because our bodies are like big batteries. We've got water, we've got iron, and we've got a negative and positive pole. We've got the masculine and feminine, or, you know, the balance of yin and yang. So we have all the same qualities as a battery. And typically, you know, our energy can be like just bouncing around in our day-to-day. But when by having another, you know, the power of two, just having our hands will actually help to calm the energy down. So bars is one of those body processes that will dissipate that heaviness in the thing that we can gift and receive to each other. So how about you all? Tell us about you and energy.
I haven't gone deeply into the Body Works program, but I was taught how to tap your cortices, and that has been a life-changing thing for me. If I have a sore hip, if I have a sore shoulder, I do that a couple times a day for maybe 3 days, and my body is back in balance. So that process kind of has changed the way I look at my health.
Wow, cool.
So that's tapping?
Like this one?
Yeah. Where you tap on your forehead and on your chest. My brother taps with his middle finger when he does this. I don't think that works. People tend to think you're a little goofy until they actually try it and find out that it works.
Yeah. That does. I remember taking a session with somebody in Regina with doing tapping, and that really does relax you. I think, have you ever done muscle testing? And there's another way of energy, the heart, the emotion code, muscle testing. And if you want to pick up a food or a pill or a medication and just check to see how your body reacts to it. Mm-hmm. And lots of naturopathics use this method as well. And I noticed when I was on medication, when I put it close to me and I say, my name is Lorraine, and my name is Joe, and you just stand still, and all of a sudden, because you're saying your name is Joe, your body will fall either backwards or forward depending. And then you say your real name, like my name is Lorraine, and then it will indicate where the truth of who you are. So when you hold your a bottle of pills or even a supplement you buy over the counter on your close to you, and you do the same thing, is this good for me? And you just stand, and if your body sways to the truth part, you know it's good for you. Otherwise, you go to the non-truth. And it's very interesting to do that with even food, maybe something that you haven't eaten before, or maybe in between organic, or I haven't done it with a food, organic or non-organic food, but the body knows about you if it's good for you.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, this kind of goes with that light and heavy, because if the truth will always make us feel lighter, and a lie will always typically make us feel heavier.
Yeah.
And often checking in with our bodies and saying, hey body, what would this serve me? Is this good for me? There's usually a way that the body will either say, oh yes or no. So this is a thing that I think, as we keep tuning into our bodies, we can really start to trust what they're saying. But we don't often just take that time to just tune in. Like, I'll go into the kitchen and I'm just grabbing at whatever's there, as opposed to just going, what does my body really need right now? Because there's actually four food groups. There's water, salt, sugar, and energy. And those are the four food groups. And we don't often think that how to feed ourselves with some energy, as opposed to just grabbing for food that's salty, sweet, whatever. But often by moving, and this is where movement comes in, and I think the power of movement is sometimes I just need to move my body in order to get my energy going, as opposed to, say, going and doing something else, like maybe, having a handful of crackers or whatever that is. Sometimes I need to be, my body needs the movement, or it needs some sort of engagement through movement. So it's to really balance out that whole awareness around what would really serve my body. Maybe I just need a drink of water, and maybe I go to food too quickly. Mm-hmm. Because it's just that automatic thing. So, I mean, obviously energy and exercise, it's a very broad subject. And I know we've kind of dabbled a little bit in all of it, but.
Thank you very much, Lynn. I think I'm going to stop the recording now, but I think it really tunes us into being more aware of how to recognize the positive feeling of energy, because energy is also, even in the words you say and the language and the tone and how you hold your body, is also another form of expressing the energy. So I'm going to stop the recording and thank you very much for coming.